Hey again, I got caught making chili. Here's what we got. Some nice lean meat here. And if it looks a little funny, maybe that's because it is. This is a chili grind, a venison chili grind here. We're going to scramble this up. That's how we're going to get it started. We're going to add a little spices to this. If you want to know anything about the spices, just hit me up on the comments and I'll tell you what we got going there. We also got some chopped up vegetables to go in this. We're going to let these saute down. And they're going to be real good once they hit the big pot. We got some jalapenos, some diced yellow onions, bit of garlic, about a tablespoon and a half, I think. And we're going to let this cook down and scramble in with the meat. In our other pot, we've got some tomato sauce, an 8-ounce can. We'll use almost all of that. Not quite all. And get a couple of about a cup and a half of water. That's probably more than a cup and a half. We'll go ahead and get our seasonings going in that. And here we got a blended mix of chili seasonings. It's a chili powder, red pepper, some black pepper, some paprika, alright, we got all the seasoning stirred in here. We're going to let those kind of just try to simmer together there. When this meat gets done, we'll introduce it in one big happy pot. And you can see the way this ground, the chili grind that we have done, gives you some pretty good bite-sized chunks of chili meat. That's what you want. You don't want that stuff to be like ground hamburger meat and all scrambled like taco meat if you stir it too much. And some things we like in our chili, we like to pour it over tamales or eat it with crackers or Fritos and some good old cheddar cheese. You can have you make you a Frito pie, if that's what you like. And this is just about ready. You can see it doesn't take long to get this meat cooked up. And this meat most of the time is pretty dry. We added some olive oil into this pot before we started cooking it, to keep some moisture. And we're going to get it in the pot now. It's that easy. Once we get all this in this big pot, we're going to turn this heat up to a high boil. We're going to let this meat boil in this chili sauce. for about 30 minutes. And then we're going to cut that heat down and put a lid on it and let it simmer for about 2 or 3 hours. Be time for a football game. That's it. If you could see in there, I'm going to give it a good stir. And this is about 2 pounds. 2 pound package of the chili meat is what we have here. And yeah. You can see what we're looking at. That's going to be a nice bowl of red right there. And we'll be back in an hour. Show you what we do along the process. Alright, as you can see, we're back. It's been a couple of hours. A couple of stirs, and this chili is just about right. We're going to give it a last little stir here. Just show you what we like to do. We'll take one of these tamales that's been steamed. Lay that on the plate. Have a little chili for that. We'll sprinkle the cheddar cheese. We've got some corn chips. We'll put a ladle on it. Some cheese if you like it. Or just have a plain old fashioned bowl of chili. A few crackers. It was that easy. Took about 15 minutes of prep time, 20 minutes of cooking time, and just let it simmer. Hour and a half, and it's good. And there you go.